up, though, YouTube? Y'all already know what it is, man. It's your favorite damn DJ in the land, DJ Lixer, and I'm back with another video. If you're new to the channel, man, y'all already know what I'm gonna tell you to do. Go ahead and drop a like on the video. Go ahead and subscribe. Leave me some comments. Y'all know I'm all for the people. I'm all for the love. I'm all for the DJ community. I'm all for the culture, man. So I'm making this video basically to give you a little insight on whether you should go ahead and look to work for a DJing company, or if you should go ahead and just try being independent and doing this on your own. So hopefully at the end of this video, you'll have all the tips you need to make the decision that you need to work for yourself or to work for someone else. The very first thing we're going to talk about, you guys, today is working for yourself, the pros and the cons of working for yourself. Now, as you guys all know, I am a full-time DJ. I have no other source of income. So obviously, this video is going to be coming from my interpretation. DJs, y'all leave, you know, your feedback on how you feel about working for yourself or working for companies and all of that good stuff. But like I said, this is all coming from me and my interpretation of things, all right? One of the pros of working for yourself, y'all, is that you absolutely get to set your own schedule. What I love about working for DJ Lixer, obviously, I'm my own company, et cetera, et cetera, Lixer ENT. You know I'm Shane, the Lixer experience. Now I'm Shane. But I love the fact that I can set up my own schedule. I don't have to work on anyone else's time. This is especially incredible when you're a full-time DJ and this is all you do. Setting your own schedule really helps because guess what? There are some weekends where I know I'm not gonna wanna work. Prime example, when I have those long days during the summer, you guys, it's somebody's graduation party, it's somebody's high school all-night party, somebody's day party, a comedy show or something like that. I'm booked 7, 8, 9 day stretches. If it's possible, I can just take a break that next weekend. You want to get your hustle on, whatever, whatever, but sometimes those ears, they need a break. So I love being able to set my own schedule, being able to work for myself. Another major pro, working for yourself, you're way more in tune with your clientele. Now, when you're working for yourself, I don't know about other DJs, but I completely brand for myself. I'm my own promotion company. I have nobody else working for me. We will get there soon. You know, you speak everything into existence. But working for myself, I'm my promotion. I'm my branding team. You know, I build my websites, etc., etc. So with that being said, a lot of my gigs come from word of mouth, y'all. And when it comes from word of mouth that helps with building your clientele is that those people are more in tune to how you work as a DJ. I'm not gonna sit here and lie to y'all, man. I'm not a country DJ. I've done country weddings and things of that nature, but that's because of the companies I have worked for before. Most people who book DJ Lixer, you know, they've watched my YouTube channels, they've been on my websites, they follow me on Facebook or Instagram, some type of social media. So being more in tune with that clientele, they know, like, hey, we'll rock to some hip hop. We like old school R&B. We can do top 40. You know, it's very rare that I get a client that's not in the realm of what I like to do. So it makes it a lot easier when you know your clientele and they know what you're playing, they know what you do. Because there's some DJs that do certain things, some DJs that don't do certain things. Being in touch with your clientele and being in tune with your clientele is a major plus working for yourself. Third pro to working for yourself, obviously the most important thing is that you get to set your own prices, man. It's all about that money, you know what I'm saying? One thing I love about working for myself as a DJ is that I am able to charge however much I want to charge for whatever event that I'm doing. I don't charge the same for a wedding that I do a Sweet 16, that I do a corporate, well, I guess up here, corporate events. When you're working for, you know, yourself, you get to set those prices. You get to say, hey, I'm gonna charge so-and-so $5,000 for doing this event. And I'm not gonna lie, working for a company, I don't think you're ever gonna see a $5,000 gig, not unless they get about, you know, $20,000. And I doubt they even give you that much because you're working for them. Working for myself, I get to set my own prices, what I like to bring out, offering my clients different type of packages, things of that nature. So that's one of the major, major, major pros for working for yourself is that you get to set that price list up and you get to get that exact amount of money that you feel you are worth and you deserve as a DJ. Last but certainly not least, man, number four, but probably the most important pro, you have way more fun working for yourself, you guys. Someone hits you up and is like, yo, I want you to do this type of event. I need this, but I need you to wear this. You have the right to say yes or no. I am a firm believer in not taking gigs that I feel like I will not enjoy, because the one thing I can't stand when I used to work for, you know, certain companies is that I was doing like a hold down or something like that. And you know, I got the music, the client was happy, but I was absolutely miserable doing that event. That's when I knew, like, yo, I gotta do this for myself. I ain't with the hold downs or whatever, because that's not the type of music that I listen to. That's not what I, you know, grew up in. I'm more mainstream. I'm more hip-hop, house, top 40, even trap. I can't do no hold downs. I've done them before, but you know, that's just my preference. You got to be able to have fun with your gigs. When you're choosing your own gigs, you have a lot more, way more fun when you're doing things on your own and picking your own events. If you don't, you know, you might not be having as much fun. You might be at the hold down looking at, like I was, you know, I was sitting there like, you know, looking at my watch every 10 seconds. So the fact that you get to have way more fun is definitely a major pro, if not the best pro, of working for yourself. All right, time for the bad stuff, you guys. Some of the cons of working for yourself. And there's not much. Actually, there's really only two I could think of. Obviously, if you guys can think of something else, please let me know. Definitely the inconsistency in bookings. Now, I don't deal with this as much now as I used to, maybe when I first started DJing 5 years ago. But I'm gonna be completely honest with you, man. It's really, really hard doing this on your own. I live in Michigan, so once that snow starts falling, it gets a little chilly, it gets a little cold. People are staying in the house, so it's a lot harder for me to get bookings that way. But until it gets warm here, that inconsistency, it kind of kills your pockets a little bit, and you start getting a little worried. So that's one of the cons of, you know, working for yourself. If you don't have a name for yourself, it's going to be really, really hard to keep consistent bookings. So that's one of the major, major cons of working for yourself, is, you know, not knowing if you're going to get called for this Friday or this Saturday or this Sunday. Also, last con, the major stress it can have on your body. Now, what I mean by that is, since I'm mostly a mobile DJ, I do clubs here and there, so that helps a lot. But since I'm a mobile DJ, I have to bring all of my stuff by myself. So you guys can imagine when I have, let's say, a wedding, because those are the events that I bring the most stuff to, and I'm setting up, you know, two speakers, two subwoofers, my fog machine, moving heads, the LED lighting, etc., etc. That's a lot of stuff you have to bring in and bring out. The stress it has getting the stuff in your car, pulling it out every weekend, sometimes 4 or 5 nights in a row. It gets tough, man, and especially when, you know, I'm trying to get my, you know, get my game up, get my muscle game up, but until I get there, it does have a lot of stress on your body. And without the proper body mechanics, you guys know I did a couple of gig logs where I actually had to pay people to come set up my equipment because I was having back problems, or, you know, my legs were hurting, or, you know, I remember one time I messed up my wrist, you know, just not using proper body mechanics. So you got to know what you're doing, and you got to make sure that, you know, if you're doing this professionally, make sure you're taking care of your body, because it will have a ton of stress on you, especially if you start young. I know DJs who are now there in their 40s and 50s that, you know, have jacked up backs, ears, legs, whatever. So you got to take care of yourself. But that's probably the only other con I can think of working for yourself as a DJ. All right, now for some of the pros for working for a DJing company. First pro is that you'll potentially get more gigs. And I say potentially because depending on the type of company you're with, they're either gonna have a ton of traffic, especially during like the summer, the wedding seasons, and you'll probably be booked every week. When I first started DJing full time, which was 2 years ago, I was actually a part of 2 or 3 DJ companies at a time because I just needed to make sure that I was getting bookings. I'm not gonna lie, man, they really did have me out here. It was every weekend from about when I started June, July 2016, for about maybe 8 or 9 months. I was with 2 or 3 companies and they kept me booked. They kept it consistent because when you're working with the company, you know, more people are privy to work with the company because they're more professional, and you know, they'll call their DJs and say, hey, we need you this weekend, we need you this weekend. So it definitely worked out when I first started out. I did appreciate that I was able to keep bookings at least once a week. I was booked at a minimum once a week through any of the 2 or 3 of the companies that I was working for. So that was really nice, and that really worked out in my favor. Also, with that consistency in bookings, you'll find less time worrying about trying to get them yourself. With the company, more reputable reputation, more people are privy to come to them, and they'll keep you busy. I'm gonna be completely honest with you, man. DJing, being an entrepreneur, period, working for yourself, is a 24-hour job. Even while I'm sleeping, I'm trying to figure out ways to make money. One thing I could appreciate working for a company is that I don't have to go out, post my flyer 10 times, you know, go up to schools, talk to certain people, because they basically took care of that for you. They're finding those gigs for you. All right, pro number 2, depending on the company you're with, you'll actually save a lot of time and effort on setups. Like I said, one of the cons of working for yourself is that, you know, it puts a lot of stress on your body. Now, two of the three companies that I have worked for, depending on the situation, they would bring their own equipment. So literally all I had to do was come in, plug in my mixer, my turntable, my laptop, boogie down, actually bring some, you know, they hire an equipment guy to come and break everything down, which was really, really nice. Whenever I can just walk in, do my thing, and then dip and everybody's still, you know, doing their thing, that's absolutely wonderful. So the fact that you could save time and effort on setups, which helps, you know, save the stress on your body, that was really, really cool. And I did appreciate that, you know, when it came to working with companies. Last pro for working for a DJing company is you potentially get less paperwork. About me, when you're a professional DJ, I have a lot of paperwork that I have to cover, especially when I'm doing corporate and wedding events. And I keep bringing these up, guys, because these are the gigs that have the big money, which means you have to make sure that everything is aligned. When you're working with a company, you might have to talk to the client. And when I say might, I really do mean might. Sometimes you don't even talk to the client. One of the companies that I had worked for, they were literally like, yo, we just need you to show up. Here's a list of the music they want. We got an MC. All you have to do is play the music, which made it a lot easier. So it is less of a headache working for a company because you don't have to deal with your client one-on-one. Sometimes you can just come in, play, and you can leave. And that really does work out. All right, y'all. Some of the cons of working for a DJing company, and there are a few of them. One of the major ones that I really don't like is that you obviously can't set your own price. That's a very, very big deal for me. There are companies that will look after their DJs and take care of them. But I remember the very, very first DJing company I was a part of, they got over on all of their DJs, I'm not gonna lie. They got over a ton of their DJs. I mean, I'm doing weddings, you guys, and I'm at the end of the night, I'm getting paid maybe $150, $200. That's it. And I mean, in their defense, you know, they provided, you know, the clientele, they provided the speakers and the lighting, et cetera, et cetera. But I've never felt comfortable getting paid $200 for a wedding, especially when you're getting paid, you know, $4,000-$6,000 for these weddings and you're paying your DJs not even 10%. I always felt like that was an issue while we're talking about payments, is that you also have to wait to get paid. There's no such thing as doing your gig, getting paid before, or getting paid the day of. I know for some companies, like I said, I was a part of a couple when I first started DJing, I used to have to wait every 2 weeks. So if I did an event, if I did 3 events 1 week and then I did 2 events the next week, I had to wait for all of that money for 2 weeks. I'm not sure how you guys work, but I know working for myself, I have all of my payment before I even set up for my event. You have to pay me in full before I even come and set up a speaker, or you won't be getting a Elixir experience. But that's just how I work. I'm not sure how everyone else works. That's just how I run my business. But when you're working for other companies, you're not gonna get paid, you're just due. I'm gonna be completely honest with you. And you're gonna have to wait to get paid. And I don't know about you guys, but waiting a whole 2 weeks after doing 5 or 6 events, get a little antsy. You start getting a little irritated because you know it's like having a job. You know you're not gonna get that money for a while. So that's definitely one of the things I absolutely hate. I can't stand. It irritates me about working for a DJing company. Another major con working for a DJing company is that you have absolutely no idea who your clientele is. For me, that's a major, major, major importance, knowing who my clients are, man. I love my clients knowing who I am. I love when my clients say, we want DJ Elixir, we want that Elixir experience because we watched you on YouTube, we saw you on Facebook, blah, 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 blah. When I don't know my clientele, I don't have a feel for them. And being an entertainer, because essentially that's what I am. I'm a DJ, I'm an entertainer. And so are you. When you're a DJ, you're an entertainer. You're the pulse of that event. It makes it better when you know what your clients are looking for, who they are, what their family looks like, what their family enjoys, getting a little background. And something about me, I even include all of these questions in my questionnaires and my contracts. So I know exactly the type of mindset that I need when I go and meet up with these people or do their events. So working for a DJing company, not knowing your clientele, that's a major issue for me. And it's something difficult to deal with when you don't know your clientele. Third con working for a DJing company, man, is that you always represent the company and you never represent yourself. I actually know a few DJs who have worked for companies before and they've gotten fired because they're passing out their cards instead of the company cards. I'm not mad at that, man, because if I owned a DJing company or something of that nature, and I'm telling you, you know, I'm booking you and I'm paying you to do a service, you're not supposed to be handing out mixtapes at McDonald's. You're supposed to be doing your job. You're supposed to be making, you know, McDoubles, not passing out mixtapes. So when you're out there working, you're representing them, which can be either a good reflection or a bad reflection, because if you do an absolutely incredible job, they go back to the company. They're not going to be looking for you specifically, or they'll go to the company to try to book you specifically. But it's not like you can just go up to them and say, hey, I'm DJ Lixer, here's my card, give me a call if ever you need my services again. No, because you're representing the company. But that also works in a negative light, because if you do a terrible job, once again, it's on the company. They're not going to go with the company again. You get in trouble. You could potentially be losing your job. So representing the company, it sucks, but it's something that you absolutely have to do. So just keep that in mind. If ever you want to, you know, work for a DJing company, just know that you'll no longer be representing yourself. You'll be representing the company. Last but not least, probably the most recognized con, you have a boss. And you guys, I'm going to be honest with you. I haven't had a boss in almost 2 years, and I absolutely love it. I wake up when I want to. I do the events that I want to. I go to sleep when I want to. All that stops when you work for a DJing company, man. If they tell you, you know, you have to work on a Friday or a Saturday, and it's this type of event, it's a Sweet 16, and you hate doing Sweet 16, and they put you on the schedule, you have to do it. Now, some companies, they will ask you, you know, about your calendars, and they will ask you if you'd like to do the event. Two of the companies that I work for, they did ask me if I wanted to do the events, and I answered yes or no. I have one company that used to just book me, no matter what the event was, and that was, you know, part of the deal of working with the company. It's like, you have to be open to do all of these events. So not being able to say yes or no, not knowing your clientele, not knowing, you know, if I had a vacation I wanted to take this weekend and I just got booked last minute, all of that is out the window. So having a boss, obviously, it sucks. Nobody likes having a boss. Everybody wants to be the boss. But that's why I like DJing for myself. All right, y'all. Thanks so much for tuning in to Lixer Experience TV. You know, a little quick little tips video on whether you'd rather work for yourself or work for a company. I know it's a lot of pros and cons for a lot of things. And I'm going to be completely honest with you. If you're dibbling and dabbling and DJing here and there, you're not really serious about it. You're just trying to get a little extra check, but you like having fun and you're respecting the culture. Y'all know how I am. Always respect my culture, man. I'd go ahead and say, you know, go ahead and DJ for a company. If you don't have a name like that out there, and you just need some extra coins and you love having fun being a DJ, get with the company. You'll have the clientele you need to get yourself out there. They'll probably have you booked a lot more than you can book yourself, and it'll be a lot easier for you, especially if you're not that professional. Obviously, you know, if you're looking to be your own boss, if you have a name, or you're looking to build up yourself, you're looking to build up your self-esteem, your confidence, and you're like, fuck being with the company, I want to do this on my own, I know I can do this on my own, work for yourself, man. I'm definitely all for independence, but you know, it's a two-way street. I know DJs who are doing both. You know, just make sure if you do get with the DJing company and you are independent, it's something that works in your favor, something that works in your schedule. Don't get with someone that's going to have you booked all the time and you know you don't want to be booked all the time. Don't get with someone who's only going to pay you, you know, $100 to do a gig when you know you could be making $700 or $800 doing a gig. Just make sure you're making the right decisions and you'll be straight. If you really rock with this video, man, make sure you hit that thumbs up button a few times. I need 100 likes on this video, man. Let's get this to 100 likes. Y'all know how I am. I like 100 likes. I like 200 likes. I even like 1,000 likes. Just get it up there for me. Also, if you're not subscribed, make sure you're hitting that red subscribe button at the bottom. And don't forget to hit the one time for the one time. Make sure you're paying attention to your feed every time I upload a video. You see this pretty ass face popping up. And you be like, man, that's DJ Lixer. She just uploaded a video. Let me go and click on it right now, because I gotta stay up on it. Make sure you're catching me live on Facebook every Monday around 5, maybe 6 p.m. depending on the day and depending on if I'm booked or not. No, I'm just kidding. But every Monday, live on Facebook around 5 p.m. Facebook.com/DJ Lixer. I'm going live with a brand new mix. Sometimes I have a theme, sometimes I don't. Sometimes I'll be feeling it, sometimes I won't. You know what I'm saying? It's just depending on how I feel. Guess I'll see y'all in the next one, alright? Peace.